Hello, and thank you for tuning in to my quick look presentation of the presentation at RSA 2019 Asia Pacific in Japan called Fakes Aren't Funny. I'm Dr. Tom Keenan. I'm a professor at the University of Calgary in both the School of Architecture, Landscape and Planning, and also the Department of Computer Science. And I have a lifelong interest in images and image fakery, and I'd like to tell you something about it today. For starters, many of the things that we see are fake. I, for example, was doing a television interview out of New York City recently, and of course, in the lower left-hand corner, you can see the Empire State Building, but now you know how we did it. I hope I didn't spoil any illusions, but reporters don't stand out in the rain outside the Empire State Building. Everything is fake this way. The other thing that's interesting about this slide is we ran it through some analysis software. So now videos can be subjected to analysis, and we learned from this that I don't have a 5 o'clock shadow, I don't have arched eyebrows, and I'm not attractive. So images are going to become very, very important in our lives. They can also be very easily manipulated. This is a photograph, historical photograph, of the Yalta summit, and you'll notice that there are some characters in there who don't belong. Sylvester Stallone and Groucho Marx. This is an old Photoshop trick that was done a long time ago. More recently, some people thought this should be the National Geographic photo of last year because it's so impressive. And of course, the shark is not actually attacking the diver. It's a composite of two photographs. I once asked the photo editor of the New York Times newspaper, "Can you detect a fake in an image?" And this person said, "Well, I used to be able to see the razor blade marks where the negatives were cut together. But now, once it's been through a computer, there's no way." There are so many tools out there, Photoshop, InDesign, GIMP, Pixlr, Inkscape, all kinds of different image editing tools that are available to anyone. Some of them are free, some of them are inexpensive. The other thing to realize is photos are increasingly important in a social media world. So for example, tweets with images are shown to be 34% more likely to catch attention and be retweeted. There are entire platforms like Instagram and Pinterest that are image-oriented. And of course, we've had some recent examples of video fakery. In the college admission scandal, it was accused or alleged that some of the people who try to get their kids into good schools Photoshop their heads onto the bodies of athletes. So even Hollywood actresses are using video fakery. There's also a dark side to it as well. The Emma Gonzalez, who was a high school senior from the school in Florida where there were shootings, is portrayed here tearing up something, and then it's been edited to show her tearing up the United States Constitution. This was done by gun advocates or opponents of gun control, and so the politicization of image manipulation is getting very important. Another example is a video of House Speaker Nancy Pelosi that was altered to make her look like she was slurring her words. And in my presentation at RSA, we'll watch this video, brief video, and realize that it's quite easy to do. Likewise, there are great online videos in which people's mouths are manipulated to say things they would never say. So here we have former U.S. President Barack Obama, and he is actually being manipulated, his image, by Jordan Peele to say things that he would never say. And at my presentation, you'll hear what he says about Donald Trump. This is a critical business issue because we still rely on paper. We think we've gone paperless, but we haven't. Last time I got on an airplane, I got a paper boarding pass, and the reason is I didn't trust my phone battery to last. Small businesses still often use paper documents and checks. And if we go paperless, think about it, the risks for tampering are even greater because it's just an image on the screen. Now, most people are honest, but some people aren't, and the frontline staff are not really trained to detect fakes. And there are even sites that have sprung up to help people cheat. Now, how are people cheating? Well, insurance claims. You have a flooded basement, you take a picture of it, and you send it in. But it's been discovered and publicized that many insurance frauds are being abetted by image fakery. So I think there's pretty good reason why we want to think about this. I've come up with some ideas about dealing with it because I hate to raise a problem without giving a solution. And one of them would be to have a blockchain that tracks images. So if you take, for example, the famous video of CNN reporter Jim Acosta, which we'll also look at in my presentation, it was manipulated by someone who wanted to make it look like he was hitting somebody else. Now, how would you know which is the right video? Well, if there are two videos out there, if they are registered on a blockchain, the one that comes first is by definition the original. So we could set up a system that would actually detect tampering of videos or other images. The big question is who would run this system? Maybe it would be a government or YouTube or someone like that. So I hope that I've convinced you, first of all, that image fakery can be fun. Lots of people have a very entertaining time doing that. It's not fun if you are the victim. And I have examples in my presentation. For example, a big hardware chain named Lowe's was the victim of bogus $50 coupons. Someone put them up, and they were coming into stores trying to present this coupon. It turned out it was even worse because the site that served the coupons was a phishing site to try to do identity theft. So I hope you know that there are bad people out there. They also have all the tools they need to do this. It's quite possible you're being scammed right now. Come to my presentation. I'll show you how you might get a free drink on an airplane simply by putting four characters on your boarding pass. You can fight back with technical measures, and maybe some things aren't worth worrying about. The airline has actually closed the gap that allowed you to get that free drink, but they did it for other reasons. The giving somebody a free drink on a plane is not serious. However, there are issues in business where large amounts of money can be lost. We had a university in Canada that was defrauded of hundreds of thousands of dollars simply because fake invoices were being honored. I'm Dr. Tom Keenan. Again, I'm the author of a book called Techno Creep, and I'm looking forward to seeing you at Asia Pacific Japan in Singapore. Thank you very much.